They think it helps with management and also earns money. It's a great moneymaker. That's what General Motors realized. Huh, but this might actually work. Should we launch it? And that's how they started developing. Have you hit subscribe? You haven't?
There's hardly any info out there on GM's diesel engine oil standard, DexosD. So someone asked us to explain what kind of standard it is.
Dexos is a specification developed by the US automaker GM. It's their proprietary engine oil spec. European car makers use the ACEA spec, plus they often develop their own in-house oil standards. But GM didn't have its own standard like European brands did. They had been just following API specifications. It's good for both management and profit. From their perspective, it's good for management and even generates profit. It's a money-making opportunity because they get paid when they approve engine oils. So GM thought, this could work. Why not creating our own specs? That's how the Dexos specifications was born. They launched it in 2010, splitting it into Dexos 1 and Dexos 2. And Dexos 1 is the spec for gasoline-powered vehicles. Dexos 2 is for diesel-powered vehicles. Since I already covered Dexos 1 in a previous video, we'll skip that today. Dexos 2 initially followed European specs, so they had to arrange the HTHS viscosity at least 3.5 millipascal seconds. But the level of viscosity isn't really fuel efficient. So GM thought, shouldn't we develop fuel efficient version for passenger diesels too? That's why DexosD was created. DexosD development started in 2019. And most DexosD oils are 0W20. Even 5W30 can pass the fuel economy test as long as it exceeds 2.9 millipascal seconds. So yes, there are also 5W30 oil of DexosD. If you check GM's official website, there are only 22 products certified for DexosD. Out of them, there are 4 5W30 viscosity oils listed on the website. All the others are 0W20. So yeah, it's not a lot. That's because in the US, most vehicles are gasoline powered. Diesel powered passenger vehicles are relatively rare. DexosD is targeted for the European market. DexosD was created specifically for oils used in European diesel powered passenger vehicles. Brands like Castrol, Shell and Mobil 1 follow international standards. Since they also want to sell a lot in Europe, they develop oils that meet this spec. But why does Europe need such low viscosity 0W20 oils for diesel cars? Because in Europe, fuel economy is a major concern. So ACEA started creating new categories too. The AB categories are for engines without post-processing unit. A 5/B5 was introduced. And more recently, a 7/B7 was added specifically for fuel economy. Even among the C categories, which are for post-processing units, C1 was phased out, and now we have C5 and C6. C5 and C6 are both 0W20 grade fuel economy oils. As this trend grows, European OEMs also started developing more fuel economy oriented engines. That shift in direction led to, since GM has to export it, DexosD is trying to activate the 0W20 for the Dexos diesel passenger. This is the only way to use diesel for fuel economy. So then, what's the real difference between Dexos 2 and DexosD? Dexos 2 has been around since 2010. It was created alongside Dexos 1. And like I said, DexosD was created in 2019. That's already a 9-year gap. By 2019, when DexosD came out, Dexos 2 had already been upgraded. Dexos 2 focuses on high temperature viscosity performance, whereas DexosD is all about low viscosity and fuel economy. So the core difference is viscosity, not much else. There is a difference in viscosity, so there is something that is tested accordingly. If there is a difference in viscosity, the amount of evaporation called NOAC changes a bit. It also affects high temperature, high shear characteristics. Only those things have been supplemented a little. Aside from that, they're almost the same spec. Haven't you subscribed yet? Do it right now. Click that button. Dexos isn't about oil recipes. It's a standard, a specification. There are limits set for a test. Once the oil passes those tests, it can be labeled Dexos 1, Dexos 2, or DexosD accordingly. Dexos 2 was released in 2010. But that doesn't mean products from that time still use the same formula. If I say that it was developed at a different time, and you're saying, is it just a viscosity change? No, that doesn't make sense. It's hard to make it low viscosity with past recipes. I'd say it's an engine oil with a completely different formula. It's not that easy to make a recipe. There are about 20 to 30 additives involved. All of those components need to be perfectly balanced. Just throwing in ingredients doesn't make it better. It has to be precisely matched. You can't just lower the viscosity and expect it to work. Lowering viscosity can cause a lot of other things to deteriorate. So getting it right requires carefully blending different base oils. It's definitely not easy. Now, this is the realm of experts or creative developers. One more thing about Dexos, here's some additional info. There's something called DexosR. It's for racing. Now, there are only 5 products that meet this spec. Interestingly, they're all from Mobil 1. 4 of them are 0W40, only one is 5W50. Is it the answer to your question? For accurate information on lubricants, stay with Enbuljin. This was Dr. Kim Bohun, your lube expert. Please like and subscribe and turn on notifications. See you next time, everyone, okay?
Come out! Come out! Come out!